This is the Sun Bowl in El Paso, Texas. You can see it's warm, 74 degrees. It'll cool off a little later tonight, but still ideal conditions for both the Miners and the Cougars. The series, well, it's unbalanced for the Cougars. A big disadvantage for the host team, and BYU has been dominant. Last year's game, 40-18, was a game of big plays. 100-yard kickoff return by James Dye of BYU. It was a 100-yard interception for a touchdown by Michael Hicks, who's a defensive back for UTEP, who will play in this game tonight. BYU's won the last 10 meetings, and as stated it earlier, 24 out of 25 games. Jason Frank will kick off for the Miners. Number 26, he'll place it on the tee at the 35. And the kickoff is brought to you by Ford and your local Ford dealer. Of course, an area of concern for UTEP, Blaine, they have not defended kickoffs and punts well this year. And they're concerned about Jaron Dabney. Back there with Omar Morgan, and it will be Dabney. To the 25-yard line goes Dabney. The quarterback, the freshman, the true freshman, Drew Miller, who had the splendid game against TCU. Three second-half touchdowns. There was a flag on that kickoff. So you can see Miller looking on, wondering where he will start from.
Isn't amazing, Randy, that when you play on artificial surface, the quick players seem to be even quicker. And Dabney, with outstanding speed, looked awfully quick on that first kickoff return. Start out with a personal foul. Lavelle Edwards on the BYU sideline will.
Well, not ideal starting spot for a freshman quarterback, Drew Miller, but he'll come in and begin from the 12-yard line. Effervescent young guy.
You mentioned this starting spot, his first play as a BYU. Play where he went in and BYU had the ball on their own 1-yard line and was sacked for a safety against Rice earlier in the year. So this should seem like no big deal compared to that situation.
Brian McKenzie is the tailback, the deep back in the I formation. Play fake by Miller. And they'll set up the screen to Dustin Johnson. That's a good first down call and a big gain for Dustin Johnson, who's down the sideline and run out of bounds near the 30-yard line. What a way to start for the Cougars.
A big first down play and a big confidence booster for the young quarterback. They're going to bring Dustin Johnson from the right side of the backfield across on a screen play, bring the entire left side of that offensive line out in front. And Dustin Johnson gets some good blocks downfield, just heads up the sideline. He has great straight ahead speed, and he uses that speed to get a big gain for BYU on first down.
Went out of bounds at the 32 of the Miners. Ben Cahoon in motion. Another completion to Margin Hooks inside the 20, and that's another BYU first down. Dropped by Dale Curry. Here are the starting lineups brought to you by Gene Harvey Chevrolet. Our ambition is your total satisfaction. Ben Archibald, big shoes to fill tonight. John Tate is injured, will not play. Archibald goes at left tackle. Aaron Roderick, wide receiver, had two touchdowns a week ago against TCU. He has 12 receptions coming in, four of them for scores. First down, close to the 19 of the Miners. Johnson running wide. UTEP does a nice job with the left end. Brian Young sealing off the play.
Let's look at the defensive starters for the Miners. Leif Larson, a 4.75 40-yard dash for the 275-pounder. He can get up the field and pass rush. Dale Curry, the top linebacker for the Miners, comes into this game with two sacks. He likes to blitz the quarterback. And the strong safety, Magatatia.
Close.
And
not correct,
a tough name, but a tougher player. And they love him back there. One of the most pleasant surprises for the Miners. He is all over the field.
Muagututia.
There you go.
Second down and nine. Johnson with a good block for McKenzie, and he turns the corner down to the 12. Joe Russillo, free safety, drove him out of bounds.
Watch John Mawala, 84, make the block on right. He holds him up just enough to allow McKenzie to get around the corner. BYU struggled to be able to make that block this year to contain the outside linebackers in the ends to allow McKenzie to get outside. That time, Mawala did a good job. And you look at LaVell Edwards' career record against the Miners, 23-1.
The one loss, 1985, right here by a touchdown, 23-16. McKenzie straight ahead. And very close to a first down. Brent Henderson with the stop. There's Charlie Bailey, noted for defense. Record is lopsided, 9-36-1. Trying to turn this program around, and it hasn't been easy. It is a first down for the Cougars. First and goal to go. You know, we had Halloween last night. This field looks like Halloween. I know the green and the red colors, orange colors. Drew Miller has his team on a sustained march to begin the game. McKenzie again off tackle. Has 4 yards to the six. Let's look at today's keys to the game, brought to you by AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. For the Cougars, avoid mistakes. They got to stay balanced. They've been balanced on the drive.
They really do. And for UTEP, they have to get a good start and get the crowd involved. They need to get some takeaways. They need to force some turnovers and have some big plays. So they've got to get a good start right here. BYU's getting a good start and could take the crowd out of this right from the start.
Johnson and McKenzie are the backs. Second and six for the school. McKenzie is wrestled down at the 4-yard line by Dale Curry, inside linebacker who's been one of the top tacklers for the Miners the last couple years. BYU will be looking at third and goal. 3 minutes into action, and BYU set this up with a screen pass to Dustin Johnson. Big play that got him down deep in Miner territory.
I expect to see big plays in this football game out of BYU offense. The Miner defense runs around a lot. They move around. They run crazy coverages. They try to confuse you, but every once in a while, they blow an assignment and give up a big play like they did in the Dustin Johnson screen pass for long yardage.
Cougars need 4 on third down. The fade incomplete. Contrary with good coverage of the deep secondary, and Ben Cahoon could not get free, and BYU will have to settle for the 3-point try.
Perfect body position that time by David Cotchery. He was inside, he forced Cahoon into the boundary and could not make a play at all on the football. Just good, solid defense on the play.
Owen Potchman on for a short field goal try. 11:25 left in the first quarter. Cougars trying to get on the board first. She's been very strong from the 40 to 49 range. This one a 21-yard attempt, and the Cougars strike first. Nice drive by BYU. Certainly they would have liked to have gotten the touchdown. They settle for the field goal from Potchman. It's 3-0 BYU early in El Paso, Texas. 21-yard field goal by Potchman. The big play was the 55-yard screen pass to Dustin Johnson. And the Cougars move quickly. And they lead by 3-0. And now Owen Potchman will be kicking off. Potchman hitting that one well, and it will not be returned. Golson kneels down in the end zone, and here's the quarterback, John Rayborn, just a junior. He's from Arlington, Texas. Had a lot of injury trouble. Twice this year, he separated his shoulder. Been in and out of the lineup. So like the Cougars, Paul Shoemaker, he's been banged up, but he's healthy and ready to go tonight.
Talked about Rayborn's penchant to make big plays. He also has a tendency to try to throw it into traffic too often. Comes into this game with the 9 interceptions. against only four touchdowns. They'd like to see him be a little more careful with the football.
That's not the only four touchdown passes and the nine picks as Joseph Pope takes it upfield for a couple yards. Rob Morris makes the tackle. The starting lineup offensively, Anwar White, three-year letterman, two-year starter, a very consistent, strong offensive lineman. And Joseph Pope led this team in rushing a year ago. He's rushed for over 300 yards this year. He's had two 100-yard-plus games already this season. Second down and seven for John Rayborn in the offense of the Miners. It's a UTEP team that averages only 13 points a game. They've struggled offensively. Rayborn passing. And he has Carpenter. And Carpenter finally dragged out of bounds by Brad Martin at the 40. And that's a first down for the Miners.
Let's take a look at the defensive starters for the BYU Cougars in this football game. Isaiah Mongale really came along over the defensive points lead on that defensive line. Solid player at the tackle. Rob Morris, the leading tackler on this football team, that middle linebacker with 61 tackles. And Tyler Nelson, a converted quarterback, had moved over to strong safety, gets his third straight start, and he's really starting to play well and feel comfortable at that strong safety position for the Cougars.
Well, John Rayborn will feel more comfortable integrating that pass in. Elzie Johnson for 1 yard to the 41, and he was smacked good. Omar Morgan came up. We talked so much about Omar Morgan and his skills covering passes, but that was a pretty good collision.
Yeah, his reputation isn't that he's a great hitter, but he does come up and he will make the tackle. Teams have had a tendency since he's been back in BYU's lineup in the secondary to throw away from him. They'll test him early in the game, and he's right there making some pass deflections, and then they seem to try to go the other way, which has made Ben Cook a better football player. I think he's improved all year as a result of all the attention that he gets in football games.
We have a dead ball, unsportsmanlike, defense, automatic first down, 15 yards.
Rayborn and Carpenter, a dynamic combination that we talked about on our pregame, and here's that play fake where Rayborn finds Carpenter.
Carpenter had lined up as the inside receiver, cleared out on the outside, then Rayborn ran an out route. Nice catch to turn back to the inside and make that catch, the ball that was thrown behind him for the first down for the Miners.
A couple of personal foul calls against BYU. Remember the opening kickoff, they were hit with one, and now this 15-yard infraction takes it to Cougar territory inside their 45. Another strike to Carpenter. Ben Cook ran him out of bounds, but a first down for UTEP.
That time El Paso spread the field out. They went with four wide receivers, two on the right and two on the left and a single back, and just sent Carpenter up the sideline. BYU trying to play two deep. The help was back deep with Nelson. He didn't get over to help Ben Cook. Ben Cook was the underneath coverage. And then Nelson is the coverage on top. You see Cook trailing the play, and Nelson doesn't get over in time to defend on Carpenter on the outside.
Two catches, 41 yards for Carpenter in this first quarter drive. And Polk is tied up in knots by Rob Morris. Middle linebacker breaking through for BYU. I got a feel that Charlie Bailey feels the same way you and I do, Blaine, that his team's not going to have great success on the round, and he's going to be forced to throw the football.
Yeah, he will have to throw the football eventually. He wants to run a little bit just to keep the defense honest. You have to at least give some token run. And what happens is when El Paso blocks down on the other backer, Rob Morris sees a hole and shoots through that hole to make the tackle on Joseph Polk.
Second and 14. That was a loss of four. Big play by Morris defensively. And Rayborn, pressured by Ed Keel, had to unload. Number 56 for BYU. Quick off the ball, pressured this man, John Rayborn.
Cougar down on the field. Looks like Byron Frisch, the big defensive end for the Cougars, leads this team in sacks with four, and they can't afford to have him hurt. He seems to be the best defensive lineman at getting pressure on the quarterback. 11 hurries so far this season, and They don't like to see him down on the ground.
Yeah, you mentioned the 11 hurries. He's been a solid citizen all season long. That front four of BYU has 8.5 sacks combined, and Frisch has 4 of the 8.5. He's getting up, and he's hobbled a little bit. And as you go down the stretch, and we're in November, he's the kind of player you certainly need in there. As Carlos Nuno comes in to replace him, these are the kind of players you need to have down the stretch if you're going to win out and get to a bowl game. This game was brought to you in part by the 62,000 proud professionals at Delta Airlines who put you on top of the world. Well, the Miners have a big play here on 3rd and 14. BYU leads by 3-0, 9:10 left in the first quarter. With Holly Rowe and Blaine Fowler, I'm Randy Rosenblum, and we're at the Sun Bowl in El Paso, Texas. And that BYU defense playing that pass very well. Just a flare to Elzie Johnson. And the linebacker Brad Martin ate him up.
Brad Martin playing underneath man coverage. He's got Elzie Johnson all the way. And as soon as he releases out of the backfield, Martin's running with him, closes down and makes the tackle. Good play. Martin, such good speed from sideline to sideline. He's in on all kinds of tackles. Comes into this game with 60.
Matthew Finley calling a timeout. Freshman place kicker. First timeout for the Miners. Counter the three-point field goal that BYU was able to get from Owen Potchman from 21 yards. And the story of this first drive was the passing of John Rayborn to flanker Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carpenter. I called him the president, didn't I?
From Plains, Georgia, Jimmy Carpenter. Also, El Paso helped out on this drive by an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. A personal foul and unsportsmanlike conduct already here in the first quarter against the Cougars. 30 yards and penalties on what I think Lavelle Edwards would term as mental mistakes.
You know, UTEP always likes to play against BYU. They know it's a physical game, and Charlie Bailey amplified on the point that, hey, his team gets up for the Cougars. Well, we're going to try that field goal before we hear from Charlie Bailey. And it's no good, so BYU will hold on to its 3-0 lead. Well, a good drive, and it stalls. You can see Charlie's not happy. This is the Blue and White Sports Network. BYU has the ball at their 25 after Matt Finley of El Paso misses from 42 yards. Cougars lead 3-0 on the Potchman field goal of 21. 8:30 left in the opening quarter. There's the starting quarterback tonight for BYU, freshman Drew Miller. Offensive line moved early. That ball was picked off by Cotchery, but it was blown dead. Well, Byron Frisch was shaken up for the Cougars, so let's go to the sideline with Holly Rowe and get an update on Byron.
Guys, the team physicians did a very thorough examination. They had him put some weight on it. They said it's fine. There's no break. It looks like just a sprain at this time, and what they're doing now is they're just going to tape him back up and let him go back out there and see if he can play through the pain. It's not a break. It looks like just a sprain at this point.
All right, Holly, so good news for the Cougars. Byron Frisch, obviously a guy on defense that is a very big part of that front four. After the 5-yard infraction, it's 1st and 15. And McKenzie is stalled. Zach Worth, left outside linebacker, with the tackle as the Cougars continue to work on Byron Frisch.
Just trying to get the ball deep to Brian McKenzie and create a seam, but Zach Worth scrapes from that linebacker position, then shoots the gap, comes from behind, and pulls Brian McKenzie down. Worth with good speed up the field. He's a guy that can get to the football quickly.
Miners showing blitz. Miller counters by going into the shotgun. Jason Smith, the nose tackle, in to Drew Miller. Jason Smith, a transfer from Sacramento City College, had an outstanding game a couple weeks ago against San Jose State. Keep in mind, UTEP, very fresh football team. They're coming off a bye week.
Now Miller's going to step back. He sees this here. He sees the linebackers up. He's going to move back, and then Smith's going to, the linebacker's going to back off, and they're going to come anyhow. Now this is something that El Paso can do. They can confuse you. They do a lot of twists. They bring different backers. They bring safeties, and with a young quarterback, he may be confused today, and we may see some sacks from this crazy UTEP defense.
And McKenzie trying to cut back, and he ran into Brian Young. Also there, Brett Henderson. And BYU, three and out this time. Back to the sideline on Holly Road.
Randy Blaine, this UTEP defense has improved every game out this year. In fact, they've only allowed one touchdown in the last eight quarters of play. They gave up 50 points a game in their first three, and then only 21 points per game in their last four. They went from 115th in the nation last year in defense to 38th. Charlie Bailey always with a good defensive team here.
Yeah, they gave up 55 at LSU and 56 at Utah. Hartsfield kicking it away to Javier Sanchez, and a good kick by J.D. Hartsfield. Good hang time. Sanchez and Derek Stevenson able to wrap him up. Well, the Cougar lead is 3-0. Two teams that play tight defense. Not unexpected to be a 3-0 game in this first quarter. We'll see what UTEP can do. Rayborn and Carpenter and Company when we come back. Well, the Cougars, they don't get shut out very often, do they? 283 consecutive games now with the field goal from Owen Pochman. Scored 31 points last week, a breakout game for the Cougars in the second half. But early on here in El Paso, it's a 3-0 lead for BYU. And UTEP begins from its 45. James Thompson, the motion man. Joseph Polk finds it tough treading in the middle of the line. That defensive front all over him, led by Darren Yancey. Throughout the game, watch for score updates brought to you by Christensen Auto, Utah County's number one auto dealership. Joseph Polk will go to the sideline. Three great backs at UTEP. Joseph Polk, LZ Johnson, and Paul Smith, all three will rotate. That's one of the luxuries of the Miners. If there's a strength of the football team, it would be those three running backs.
And they're fresh all the time, all of them averaging over 4 yards a carry. Very effective trio of backs.
Ray is open. And Allen Ray running hard to the Cougar 40. Nice effort by Ray. Tyler Nelson finally wrestled him down.
And Allen Ray was the wide receiver on the right side of the offense, and he came off the line of scrimmage like he was going to go on a streak and then just stopped. The ball was thrown on time. When he stopped, the ball was already in the air. Almost impossible to defend. Made a nice run after the catch.
15-yard gain to the Cougar 40. Second back is Smith. Paul Smith had 112 yards in the last game against San Jose State, and he's a hard running back. He's just one of these guys that goes all out all the time. Ran into another game, Spencer Reed. But Paul Smith's a good one. You can see the numbers from the San Jose State game. Second and five. And it's Smith again. First down yardage and more. Tripped up and lost the ball.
You see the Cougars signaling they have it, but the officials say the ball was down. The Miners maintain possession.
Paul Smith was shot out of a cannon.
A little trap block inside. You pulled Robert Carter from that left guard position. He kicks out the tackle. You get Paul Smith up inside, and you can see that when the ball hit the ground, it came out.
Yeah, the ground cannot cause a fumble, and it was the ground, that hard turf here at Sun Bowl Stadium. So Paul Smith comes in and ignites the running game for the Miners. Second drive of the night. And it's Smith again, twisting and turning down to the Brigham Young 20-yard line. Darren Yancey stopped him, the left defensive tackle, junior from Blackfoot, Idaho. Good numbers for Smith, and again, all three of the backs, almost identical numbers, all interchangeable parts. Smith's come in, carried it three times, every time for 5 yards. 3 for 15 in the total. And a good drive for the Miners. And it'll be Smith again trying to run wide. This time BYU able to close, and Tyler Nelson's been prominent, bringing down ball carriers for the Cougars.
Two previous plays, the Miners brought motion across the field and Brad Martin ran with it in man coverage. This time they stayed in zone and Brad Martin was over there, an extra guy on defense on that weak side for BYU. And having that extra guy made the difference, they're able to bring Smith down without much gain.
Third and three. Rayborn being pursued and throws this one away. Wanted Carpenter, and it was Rob Morris that was pursuing Rayborn, and he's limping.
Omar Morgan in coverage that time. He's going to roll out to the right here looking for a receiver. The motion man here is going to go up the field and clear out, and then he's going to look for the underneath receiver. Omar Morgan right there. This is probably a ball that should not have been thrown in there, but Rayborn was being harassed at the time. Rob Morris going to come up and put the hit on, and you can see the coverage there. Morgan in good coverage that time. Probably should have just thrown the ball away.
Finley has missed two of them. And the natives a little restless. Charlie Bailey upset with his kicking game. Ricky Bishop had been the number one kicker for the Miners, and he's injured, bad knee, and done for the year. And Matt Finley tried it and missed it. Again, we mentioned that Charlie Bailey likes to play BYU, knows it's a physical game, and earlier he talked to us about it.
Like I say, our players get excited whenever they play against BYU, and the fans in El Paso come out for that football game. When BYU comes to town, we're going to have a good crowd. And those people get behind us, and it's just something there that UTEP, you know, is always on the bottom, but they always play BYU well.
Derek Wright denying McKenzie as he tried to go up the middle. And the Miners are tough defensively. It's hard to believe, Blaine, this football team gave up the 55 to LSU and 56 at Utah. Utes had, what, 42 at halftime against this club? But they're playing a spirited defensive first quarter after that first drive.
In those games when the big points were scored, they gave up a lot of big plays. And when they've played well, they've been able to contain the big plays. On a down-for-down basis, they've been pretty good. They just get out of position once in a while.
Play fake by Miller, and he's being pursued. Muagututia, the strong safety. Halakaani Muagututia. And he's had an all-whack type of year. They just rave about his performance in the Lone Star State.
Well, he's going to come off that strong safety, and the Miners like to do this. They'll bring safeties. Muagututia comes into this game with 3 sacks. That's his 4th on the year, and he has 67 tackles. This guy is everywhere on the field. And when I talked to the BYU coaches, they said, this guy is a good football player. He's all whack caliber.
And he's a physical player. He'll throw his weight around. Third and 20 for Miller. Buying time with a flag down. Incomplete and nearly intercepted on a ball intended for Ben Cahoon. That's quite a matchup with Hicks and Cahoon. You talk about key matchups individually. Cahoon and Hicks is a dandy.
Well, Hicks is their best cover guy, and he is very big for a corner. 6'3 and 216 pounds. And Drew Miller's going to throw this up. It starts to float. It's a duck. Hicks has the interception, and Cahoon does what you teach a receiver to do. If you can't get to the ball, you make sure that the defender doesn't catch it. Now watch Ben Cahoon. Now he's the defender. He goes up and strips the football away from Hicks. A good defensive play by an offensive receiver on that one.
J.D. Hartsfield with a broken toe, but it's on his plant foot. He's in there to try to kick it out of harm's way at Javier Sanchez. Back near the 50-yard line, set to return. Sanchez from the Cougar 49. Now to the 42. So the Miners will have excellent field position in BYU territory in the final 46 seconds of the first quarter. This is the third penetration for the Miners into Brigham Young territory. They've controlled the first quarter.
I think Charlie Bailey has to be disappointed that they don't have 6 points at this point here in the first quarter. They really should be up in this football game 6-3.
Yeah, he's got to be upset with his kicking game. And Matt Finley missing two makeable placements. Little scrimmage from the Cougar 42. And Smith, no gain. That defensive front. Byron Frischback in there, but it was Morris, Rob Morris, the middle linebacker, that slugged him down. Back to the sideline on our Holly Road.
Guys, we're seeing the BYU offensive line struggle. A couple of reasons. Eric Bateman is playing quite injured. He's got his right hand completely taped up in a huge cast where he has those strained ligaments in two fingers. He just sprained his ankle on the very first series of the game and had to get that taped extensively. Also, Ben Archibald had to change from left tackle, from right tackle where he usually plays to left tackle where John Tate plays, and so he's having troubles adjusting as well.
And Rocky Perez in, quarterbacking the Miners, has a strike to Smith. And Paul Smith down the sideline. That's the final play of the first quarter. Smith went out of bounds at the 12. Chased out McKenzie as he tried to go up the middle. And the Miners are tough defensively. It's hard to believe, Blaine, this football team gave up the 55 to LSU and 56 at Utah. Utah, what, 42 at halftime against this club? But they're playing a spirited defensive first quarter after that first drive.
And in those games when the big points were scored, they gave up a lot of big plays. And when they've played well, they've been able to contain the big plays. On a down-for-down basis, they've been pretty good. You just get out of position once in a while.
Play fake by Miller, and he's being pursued. Muagututia, the strong safety. Halakahani Muagututia. And he's had an all-whack type of year. They just rave about his performance in the Lone Star State.
He's going to come off that strong safety, and the Miners like to do this. They'll bring safeties. Muagututia comes into this game with 3 sacks. That's his 4th on the year, and he has 67 tackles. This guy is everywhere on the field. And when I talked to the BYU coaches, they said, this guy is a good football player. He's all-whack caliber.
And he's a physical player. He'll throw his weight around. 3rd and 20 for Miller. Buying time with a flag down. Incomplete and nearly intercepted on a ball intended for Ben Cahoon. That's quite a matchup with Hicks and Cahoon. You talk about key matchups individually. Cahoon and Hicks is a dandy.
Well, Hicks is their best cover guy, and he is very big for a corner. 6'3 and 216 pounds. And Drew Miller's going to throw this up. It starts to float. It's a duck. Hicks has the interception, and Cahoon does what you teach a receiver to do. If you can't get to the ball, you make sure that the defender doesn't catch it. Now watch Ben Cahoon. Now he's the defender. He goes up and strips the football away from Hicks. A good defensive play by an offensive receiver on that one.
J.D. Hartsfield with a broken toe, but it's on his plant foot. He's in there to try to kick it out of harm's way at Javier Sanchez. Back near the 50-yard line, set to return. Sanchez from the Cougar 49. Down to the 42. So the Miners will have excellent field position in BYU territory in the final 46 seconds of the first quarter. This is the third penetration for the Miners into Brigham Young territory. They have controlled the first quarter.
I think Charlie Bailey has to be disappointed that they don't have 6 points at this point here in the first quarter. They really should be up in this football game 6-3.
Yeah, he's got to be upset with his kicking game. And Matt Finley missing two makeable placements. Little scrimmage from the Cougar 42. And Smith, no gain. That defensive front. Byron Frisch back in there, but it was Morris, Rob Morris, the middle linebacker, that slugged him down. Back to the sideline on our Holly Road.
Guys, we're seeing the BYU offensive line struggle. A couple of reasons. Eric Bateman is playing quite injured. He's got his right hand completely taped up in a huge cast where he has those strained ligaments in two fingers. He just sprained his ankle on the very first series of the game and had to get that taped extensively. Also, Ben Archibald had to change from right tackle where he usually plays to left tackle where John Tate plays, and so he's having troubles adjusting as well.
And Rocky Perez, in quarterbacking the Miners, has a strike to Smith. And Paul Smith down the sideline. That's the final play of the first quarter. Smith went out of bounds at the 12, chased out Tyler Nelson. So freshman Rocky Perez coming in for a wounded John Rayborn.
And Perez is going to throw the ball to the outside. It's a crossing route. The outside receiver runs a slant. The inside receiver, Paul Smith, runs an out. And Walker gets caught up in that crossing route. Smith up the sideline. And knocked out of bounds by Nelson. Big play for the Miners.
Well, the Miners closing in on a score after the first quarter. The Cougars holding on 3-0.